Flav City fam, what is up? It is Bobby coming at you from the garage of the Whole Foods on the north side of Chicago, about to go into the store and do a video I've been wanting to make for a long time, all about cholesterol and the best foods to eat for lowering cholesterol and the worst foods to eat that raise your cholesterol. And it's gonna be a little contradictory to some of the science out there, because I think cholesterol really happens when you eat inflammatory foods. And I think cholesterol in general is not a bad thing. It's meant to be in your body and go to inflammation in parts of your body that are inflamed to reduce that inflammation. The problem is when you eat a lot of inflammatory foods like we do, our diet is all inflammatory with sugar, processed foods, gluten and stuff like that, cholesterol is gonna be high. But if you eat the right foods, you can lower cholesterol, and no, you don't have to avoid stuff like really good full-fat dairy and pasture-raised eggs and grass-fed beef. So let's get up there and break down the real deal behind foods to avoid and foods to eat when it comes to cholesterol. Before we get rocking and rolling, you guys, the only way this channel keeps growing the way it has is by you liking, subscribing, and sharing. And there's a bell icon right below the video. If you enable all notifications, you'll get a push as soon as we go live. That way you don't miss out. Okay, let's go upstairs, put our mask on, and do some shopping. Let's take a trip over to the breakfast aisle, because fiber is often talked about as being good for cholesterol, because fiber actually goes into your veins and it pushes out the cholesterol. It's very, very good at clearing. It's kind of like the Morgan of The Walking Dead. It clears. And one of the best fiber breakfast cereals can be oatmeal. And there's a lot of oatmeal options at the grocery store, but I've talked about oatmeal before. You have to be very careful, because oatmeal on itself is good, but when you combine oatmeal with sugar in the form of like maple syrup or brown sugar, or you top it with a yogurt that has sugar-laced ingredients, bad news. So be careful, because even if you pick up something like this, this is Bob's Red Mill gluten-free oatmeal. It's flavored. Anytime it's flavored, I get a little bit nervous, because we look at the ingredients. There's added cane sugar. How much added cane sugar? 9 grams of added sugar. 9 grams, you guys, is just over 2 teaspoons of sugar. So I would put that down. I would go for something that is unflavored. So you might go ahead and grab, where is it gonna be? This right here. Old-fashioned rolled oats. And while that is a better step up, oats score high in glyphosate. What is glyphosate? Well, glyphosate is the active ingredient in Roundup. Why the heck would oats spray high in Roundup? Because oats are sprayed with Roundup at the end of the growing process to dry them out, so it's easier to harvest. Meaning, unless you get organic oats, you're getting a healthy dose of glyphosate. So go for organic oats. Actually, I'd rather you get steel-cut oats over rolled oats, because these actually have more fiber in them. So that's what you want to do. And then if you kind of just turn around right here, and look at the wall of cereals. Yes, a lot of these are made with whole grains, but I look at something like Akashi. Yes, there's a ton of whole grains in there. But first of all, there's soy flakes is number one. Look at the added sugar, same problem as that oatmeal. So if you want a cereal, which we don't eat cereal, if you're gonna eat grains, I recommend getting steel-cut plain organic oats. This is the best cereal on the market. It's made from the guys who make Ezekiel bread. Look at this. It's Ezekiel Golden Flax. Not only is everything organic, which is really important because of the wheat, is also sprayed with glyphosate. It's sprouted. It's whole grain. How many grams of added sugar? 1 gram of added sugar. That is nothing. This is what you want. So whole grains, my friends, are good, but not when they're loaded with extra sugar and other ingredients. On their own, they're great. They clear like Morgan does on The Walking Dead. The more you start to learn about cooking oils, the scarier it is, in my opinion, because a lot of health experts will tell you if you want low cholesterol oils, live in this section right here. Canola oil, safflower oil, and sunflower oil. My friends, these are plant-based oils, and even though they are unsaturated fats, they're highly processed and highly refined. A lot of people don't know that for canola oil and all three I just talked about, they're highly processed. They'll oftentimes use a chemical called hexane to extract the oil from the plant. If they're organic, like this is, they can't. But even so, it's a fact. These kind of oils are inflammatory. Inflammatory foods are what I consider cause high cholesterol. So I would avoid these at all costs. I find it very troubling that people are recommending that. knowing you don't want to get those, what do you want to get? Well, you don't have to get saturated fats. You can live with avocado oil, one of the best heart healthy canola oil replacements, because this, just like canola oil, is high heat approved, has no flavor, and it's really, really, really good for you. So avocado oil is where you want to live, or go down there and get olive oil. Get a good olive oil for cooking, a good extra virgin olive oil for drizzling. Heck, I would even say, and I know it's a bit controversial, that you're way better off having grass-fed ghee, 100% pasteurized grass-fed ghee, or having virgin unrefined coconut oil instead of having canola oil. I know this is a saturated fat, but it has something called lauric acid, which is very, very hard to find in food. It's very heart healthy, and I think it's good. But if you're afraid of that because of the saturated fat, just live in the avocado oil land and the olive oil land. Stay away from these processed inflammatory oils that oftentimes have chemicals, unless it says expeller pressed, that is better. But still, these are inflammatory. This one is not. Eggs. Eggs are high in cholesterol, so you should avoid them, right? No, that's rubbish. Even though eggs are high in cholesterol, they don't affect your cholesterol level. In fact, studies show they increase your good cholesterol, the HDL. What cracks me up is when people go for this, egg whites. It's funny because egg white is where all of the inflammatory properties of the eggs live. So if you're eating egg whites, yeah, you're getting a lot of protein, but it's inflammatory. What did I say about inflammatory foods? That can spike cholesterol. If you are still going to eat egg whites, go for this. This is, I've never seen this before. They're pasture-raised and pasteurized egg whites. They're Vital Farms. I've never seen pasture-raised ones before in my life. That being said, go for eggs. Don't be afraid, but go for pasture-raised eggs, because pasture-raised eggs actually have a better nutritional profile than conventional eggs. Whether it's organic, whether it's cage-free, free-range, organic pasture-raised eggs are the best bang for your buck. They have more omega-3s, which are really good for anti-inflammatory. They have more vitamin E, vitamin D, and a whole host of nutrients. So go for organic pasture-raised. Skip the egg whites. Don't skip the eggs. This is the real deal. Once again, the experts tell you to avoid dairy, like yogurt, because it's high in cholesterol. And yes, it is. But once again, it's not going to spike your cholesterol. It actually reduces the bad cholesterol, the LDL. If you're going to get yogurt, though, you got to go plain, and in my opinion, get organic or grass-fed. This is one of the best on the market. This is one of the best on the market because not only is it plain and Greek style for that one, it's grass-fed. Grass-fed dairy has a superior nutritional profile to any other dairy. So stick with plain. Try to get organic or grass-fed. Don't get low-fat dairy. Low-fat is bad. You don't want low-fat because low-fat strips you away from the omega-3 fatty acids. Full fat dairy is where it's at. The one I want you to really avoid is any one that has sugar. I don't care if you're getting organic or grass-fed. As soon as they put sugar in there, and all flavored yogurts have it, this one has what? How many grams of added sugar? 9 grams of added sugar. As soon as you do that, you take a product that used to be good, not this one because it's not organic, and you make it inflammatory because of the sugar. So stick to full fat, stick to ideally organic or grass-fed, and stick to plain yogurt. It's not going to spike your cholesterol. It's actually good for you. Right over yonder is the steaks and the ground beef. A lot of people will tell you stay away from red meat. It's high in cholesterol. And once again, I'm going to say that's a little bit of a myth because there's a big difference. I just grabbed a few different packs over there. This is pasture-raised grass-fed beef. This is conventional corn-fed, grain-fed GMO beef. Conventional beef is a strict GMO grain diet. It is inflammatory. I would stay away from that for low cholesterol diets. This is organic pasture-raised grass-fed beef. Studies show this beef, even though it is ground beef or red meat, is lower amounts of cholesterol than that. And because it's pasture-raised, it's higher in omega-3 fatty acids. It's purely grass-fed and pasture-raised. This, my friends, is the kind of meat you want to eat. And if you want to limit the amount of saturated fat, look at the fat percentage. This is lean, 93% beef, 7% fat. This one is 85% beef. I would get this one if you're concerned about more saturated fats, but don't skip the red meat. Just get the right red meat. It doesn't have to be organic because all 100% grass-fed beef pretty much is organic. Just make sure it says grass-fed and grass-finished or 100% grass-fed. Otherwise, they can fool you. They can finish it on grain and make you think it's grass-fed. But when you do that, when you finish beef on grain, you reverse a lot of the health benefits from the grass-fed in the first point. The moral of the story is eat the right meat. Don't combine it with a bun or a steak or a steak and potatoes, because then you make it inflammatory and reverse the whole point of eating the meat in the first place. I keep talking about not eating foods that are inflammatory. And like I said, if you combine ground beef with a bun, that's inflammatory. If you combine yogurt with sugar, it's inflammatory. But sometimes you want foods that can be inflammatory because you're human. You have a craving. Well, if you get regular pasta like this, this is regular wheat pasta, regular wheat. All gluten, in fact, is inflammatory. And if you get non-organic wheat, it's sprayed with Roundup as a desiccant, as a drying agent. So if you need your pasta fixed and you want to do it low inflammation, come over here and get something made of beans. Ideally, organic beans. Otherwise, conventional beans, once again, score high in Roundup because of glyphosate. Monsanto ruining everything in the world. This is amazing spaghetti. It's made with organic red lentils. No other ingredients. Fantastic texture. I love this. Have that on its own. Combine it with the sauce. It's great. We're making a new cookbook right now, as some of you might know, a 5-ingredient semi-homemade clean eating cookbook. This pasta is unbelievable. It's made with organic eggs, which I've never seen with a pasta before, and it's made with organic brown rice, a whole grain, non-gluten grain. It is very eggy, and I made a 5-ingredient tagliatelle with wild mushrooms, kale, and a Parmesan cheese kind of ragu sauce. Amazing stuff. And the same applies for bread. Let me show you real quick. Here we go. If you're gonna eat bread, Ezekiel, just like the cereal, makes an organic, sprouted, whole grain bread that has best-in-class ingredients. Still, I would limit this kind of stuff because it still is a bit inflammatory because it's wheat. If you want your bread fixed and you don't want to spike inflammation, these guys make a keto, completely grain-free bread. It is very expensive, I know, but it is the best ingredients I've ever seen for a keto bread. Look at those fantastic ingredients. Look at those fantastic macros, completely non-inflammatory. And if you want your bread fixed, I would get something like that. I know these guys, Julian Bakery, make it too, but it's more expensive. It's very dense and heavy. I'd go with that. But just be careful with wheat and grains. They have to be organic and they have to be whole grains. All right, family, that is it for the cholesterol lowering food review. A lot of good stuff in there. And speaking of anti-inflammatory foods, if you saw my live stream the other day, you saw me announce that my first ever Flav City product is coming to market this fall. It's the Flav City Immune System Boosting Tea Powder. It's the powdered form of my famous turmeric immune boosting tea with organic, non-GMO, best in class ingredients. The other day I created a pre-sale sign-up list. I'll put the link down below. First run is going to be extremely limited quantity. If it goes well, hey, maybe we'll be in Whole Foods. Maybe we'll be in Costco, but check it out. It's going to be fantastic, and I think there's a big demand in the market, especially now, for that kind of supplement. Like, subscribe, share. That's the only way this channel keeps growing. I look like Joe Biden with my mask hanging off my ear. I got two more videos below me right now, but I will see you soon. Art, who's back at home, waiting for me to get back there and do a live stream. We'll see you soon. Hashtag keep on cooking. Mad love and peace.